Welcome everyone, my name's David Lester. I'm a Senior Research Scientist with Queensland Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. I'm based in Toowoomba and I'm presenting some work today that's conducted as part of a GRDC funded project on soil constraints. This project is being led by University of Southern Queensland with Professor John Bennett. And it's in collaboration with the University of New England team and ourselves at DAF.
Where we are here today is one of six core experiments that are being conducted across the northern region. We are exploring different options in how to increase yields through changing soil water availability. The focus of this research is both a combination of both physical and chemical treatments on the soil, where we are exploring interactions between nutrient placement, rate of addition, do we use gypsum, do we apply it on the surface, do we apply it at depth, do we do both? How do these treatments compare to applying high rates of feedlot manure, which is plentiful on Queensland, and a very experimental treatment given the alkalinity of the soils we are dealing with using elemental sulphur.
One of the combinations we come up with and we seek to explore is how deep is enough. In this project, we've discriminated the top 20 centimetres and the 20 to 50 centimetres. So we're dealing with two different soil blocks. The climate in the northern region is vastly different to the rainfall patterns that we see in the high rainfall zone of Victoria, where a lot of this deep amendment work has really kicked off and delivered some fantastic results. Median rainfall, annual rainfalls across the northern region might as well work on about 500 to 550 millimetres of rainfall. That's growing season events for a lot of the high rainfall zone. So the depth at which we can place our amendment has a big effect on where the amount of water you need to get into the soil to have that change is going to be. We are drier and hotter environment than we are in Victoria for growing seasons. So part of the exploration of this project is how deep do you need to be placing your amendments to really get some impact through changing or re-engineering your soil chemistry and physics, and how is that going to change the amount of water that can be stored or utilised for increasing grain yields.
Today we're at one of our soil constraint sites just east of Millmerran. Crop was planted at the end of January to Baisley sorghum. It's on 1 metre rows.
So this is one of the plots where we're just exploring what ripping effect on its own has. There's no amendment applied, no nutrients applied. It's just the physical disturbance of the soil to about that 20 to 25 centimetres deep. So the preliminary soil testing on this particular site indicated potential potassium deficiency as well as phosphorus. So this treatment here, we've deep applied 50 kilos of K and 30 kilos of phosphorus. So we used muriate of potash and MAP. And this is very similar to what we would be advocating from the deep placement project we've had running in the last couple of years. So this plot in many ways represents the new baseline for us. What's the effect of just getting deep nutrition in place, and how does that compare with then putting the surface amendment, surface and subsurface amendments on in combination with that? So the treatment we have here is application of both surface and subsurface gypsum. So the surface gypsum rate for this site is 6.5 tonnes to the hectare. The subsurface rate is we've put 13 tonnes of gypsum banded at depth. So you'll see on the footage that's aligned with this, you'll see a big orange machine, the one we've developed to modify to put our treatments at depth. And in this case, that's what we're trying here. This is the theoretical values that are required to reduce the surface sodicity, so the surface exchangeable sodium percentage to less than 3%. And half of the subsurface volumes to less than 3%. So these are the sort of numbers of calcium of gypsum that we're talking about needing to apply. So the plot we're standing in here is just a surface gypsum and deep nutrient rate. So the surface gypsum rate is designed to reduce the ESP in that top 20 centimetres of soil to less than 3%. And that's been the calculated rate that's been applied here. So this has 6.5 tonnes of gypsum. We surface spread that and then have just incorporated it through the deep tillage operations. This plot has a combination of surface applied gypsum, deep applied N and P and K, but in this case we're just trying elemental sulphur on its own. So this is the exploring how does adding the acidifying agent, elemental sulfur, help us try to combat that subsurface acidity through, as the elemental oxidizes, it forms, releases hydrogen. That hydrogen dissolves the calcium carbonate that's already in the soil here. And then that calcium is what we use to displace the sodium and reduce those acidity effects. One of the challenges we have in resolving the effects of different treatments is accounting for, is it a nutritional effect? Is it the physical effect, or is it the structural effect that different amendments provide for us? One of the treatments we have in place here is a compost treatment. So it's 10 tons to the hectare. But in order to correct out or to infer, is it just the nutrient that's being applied in those composts? We have this plot. So this has the same amount of nitrogen and phosphorus that's been applied as the compost. It's just applied in an inorganic form. So this plot has 280 kilograms of nitrogen and 100 kilograms of phosphorus that's been applied at depth. So those are the matching nutrient additions as what we have on the compost treatment. So you can see there's probably slightly a little more green here than on the composts, but it's something where the tissue testing that we do at maturity and the drone analysis should help us separate what the effects of going on here in each of these treatments is. So the plot we're in here is one which is the deep compost plot. So this is compost that's screened from the feedlot to allow us to meter it and apply it down through our machine at depth. So this has bands at 50 centimeter spacings, and we've put 10 tons to the hectare on. So there is some almost like a salt effect. You can see on the lower canopy, some of the leaves have started to dry off. And as we walk across the site, you'll see other plots where that canopy is still much more intact. So it'll be interesting to see what numbers come back with our dry matter analysis about what these potential salt impacts could be. So the plot I'm in here is one of our combined approaches. So this treatment has both compost and elemental sulfur applied in bands at depth. So the compost rate is again that 10 tons to the hectare of screened feedlot manure. And the elemental sulfur we've applied is 1.5 tons to the hectare. So this is a combination of, is it the organic matter? Is it the acidifying agent? Is it both? And because we have the individual treatments to compare against, we're able to try and separate over the long term which of these treatments is going to give us the biggest impact. As part of the experimental process, one of the treatments we have here is we put everything on. So this plot has a combination of surface gypsum, subsurface compost, and also subsurface elemental sulfur. So if you like, this is our what if we throw everything at it plot. We're not leaving anything to chance here, and it also helps us explore how the combination of treatments affect different crops over time.
Next couple of weeks are going to be a real busy time here at the site. We'll be getting some biomass cuts done to measure how much plant we have grown, what it actually looks like inside, and then we'll be moving through to harvest to see how much grain each of these treatments has grown.
Once harvest is done, then we'll be moving into following up, going back into the soil sampling, saying, look, what's been the changes on soil water? Where are we now as we move into hopefully being able to double crop into a winter cereal here, and then we can pick up some more data coming through into spring this year with the wet winter. Cheers.